In this video, we're going to take a look at this Viltrox 56mm F1.4 short telephoto lens for APS-C cameras. Hi guys, my name is Matti Sulanto and I'm a photographer. And in this video, I'm going to take a look at this Viltrox 56mm F1.4 short telephoto lens for APS-C cameras. But first, a disclaimer. This lens was sent to me by Viltrox and I get to keep the lens. I don't have to return this. However, everything I'm going to say in this video is my own opinion and this is not a paid advertisement. But because I get to keep the lens, I have to have the paid promotion label down there. And now let's get to the topic of the video and talk about this lens. So this is a short telephoto lens for APS-C cameras. And the angle of view and the depth of field characteristics equal to about 85mm f2 full frame lens. And this is available for the most common APS-C mirrorless cameras, Canon M, Fuji X, Sony E and Nikon Z or Z mounts. My test setup was, of course, this lens and the Sony A6400 camera body, which is on loan from Sony Finland. Big thanks to them. But I also shot a few pictures on my Sony A7C full-frame camera, which I used on APS-C mode. However, that is a little bit unpractical for lens testing purposes because the file size is only about 8 megapixels. The build quality of this lens feels very, very nice. This is made of metal. I can't see any plastic parts. The focus ring is wide and really smooth, but of course it's a focus by wire system as it is on every autofocus lens. Also the aperture ring is smooth and stepless, clickless. I like the aperture ring itself, but I wish they would use clicks because that would be so much more convenient and also practical in photography because then you can count the clicks and you know where you are even without looking at the aperture scale. And this aperture ring also gives you another sort of command dial if you happen to have a camera body that only has one proper command dial, like many, if not all, Sony APS-C cameras. But there is the A position also on the ring, aperture ring, so you can control the aperture also from your camera if that's what you prefer. Viltrox doesn't claim any kind of weather sealing, and that can be a minor downside or maybe a bigger downside depending on where you plan to use this lens. This Sony E-mount version weighs in at about 345 grams with the included hood and the filter size is 52 millimeters. So this is quite a compact lens, but it feels a little bit heavy for its size because I guess because of the all metal construction, which is not a bad thing at all. There's also a USB mini connector on the mount, which can be used to update the firmware. And I tried it and the update was probably the easiest firmware update I have ever done. One, download the firmware file from Viltrox website. Two, connect your lens to your computer and it will appear as an external hard drive. Three, drag and drop the firmware file that you downloaded onto the lens that appears as an external hard drive. Four, unplug the lens and you're done. And as always, I recommend you to use or update the latest firmware on whatever device you have, camera, lens or whatever, because that's usually going to give you better performance and maybe added features too. Would you like to join in for 1 week of photography goodness in the form of a workshop in August 2022 with me and Peter Forsgaard?
If your answer is yes, now is the time to check out the link down below and sign up as soon as possible, because our very limited amount of 10 spots seem to sell like hotcakes. So please check out the link down below, and I'll see you in Helsinki in August 2022. And then the sharpness. At wide open f1.4 aperture, this lens is reasonably sharp in the mid part of the frame. However, towards the corners and edges of the frame, the sharpness kind of fades a little bit. But if you shoot something like portraits or something similar, it really doesn't matter. And also the depth of field at wide open aperture is so shallow that the corners usually don't matter. But if you shoot something like landscape at f1.4, you are going to see that the corners and edges are not as sharp as the mid part of the frame. When you stop down, the sharpness will gradually increase, and also the uniformity of the sharpness will even out, and by about the f5.6 you're gonna get really sharp results across the frame from corner to corner. This Viltrox doesn't have any major distortions. There is a minimal amount of pincushion distortion, but that is not going to be distracting in any picture. And if you want, you can of course correct that in post. The vignetting is quite well under control too. I didn't find it distracting. And this lens also handles backlight pretty nicely. The contrast holds up quite well, and you shouldn't be afraid to shoot into the sun or any bright light source on this lens. However, this lens has one weakness, and that is, of course, the longitudinal chromatic aberrations, also called bokeh fringing. That is very typical weakness for these affordable lenses in general. In some situations, like in this backlight picture, it can be quite distracting and very difficult to get rid of 100% in post. But in some other situations, it's not all that distracting, like in this picture, shot wide open. But if you stop down to about f2.8 or f4, you can pretty much get rid of all those longitudinal chromatic aberrations. I would still say that the wide open f1.4 aperture is very usable in many situations, and I guess once again it comes down to the fact that if you know your gear, you're gonna get better pictures. So on this lens, learn to know where you're going to get the purple fringing, and avoid wide open aperture in those situations, and use wide open aperture in other situations where you know that you are not going to see any purple fringing. Bokeh fringing. I found that the autofocus on this Viltrox 56mm is quite fast and silent. However, in some situations it hesitated a little bit, but it was nothing major, and I never found that the autofocus would be some sort of a problem or anything. And here is a video clip that I shot on the Sony A6400, and as you can see, the lens can pretty well follow my movements when I'm walking in front of the camera. Also, the face and eye recognition autofocus works really well for both video and photography. Here's what I like about this lens. The robust build, all metal and very solid feeling. The optical performance with some reservations, but all in all, I was very pleased with the pictures I got on this lens. Nothing major to complain about that. And the aperture ring. I wish it had clicks, but I still like that there is the ring, and in general I'm a big fan of aperture rings. And then what I don't like about this lens only one thing, and that is the longitudinal chromatic aberrations, which can be somewhat distracting in some situations. But like I said before, if you learn to know this lens, they are not going to be any major problem. I just wish they were a little bit better corrected. I think this Viltrox 56 F1.4 is a pretty decent value for money. When I'm recording this video, the price on Viltrox's own online store for this Sony E-mount version is $279, which I think is really, really a good price. Some other mounts are a little bit more expensive, but still very, very affordable. And I think if you're looking for a short telephoto lens for your APS-C mirrorless camera, this Viltrox 56 F1.4 is definitely worth a look. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.